Montgomery Bus Boycott by Melania Kellebauer and Megan McLaughlin.
In 1954, the Women's Political Council proposed changes to the Montgomery bus system. When the effects of the meeting caused no change, the Women's Political Council president, Joanne Robinson, again voiced the council's requests in a letter on May 21st to Mayor Gale, telling him, "There has been talk from 25 or more local organizations of planning a citywide boycott of buses." On March 2nd of 1955, Claudette Colvin, 15, was arrested for refusing to give up her seat on a Montgomery bus. In October of 1955, Mary Louise Smith was arrested for refusing to give up her seat for a white man. In the year 1955, Rosa Parks refused to give up her seat on a Montgomery bus so a white man could sit there. Rosa Parks was arrested for this on December 1st of 1955. The Women's Political Council orchestrated a one-day protest on Montgomery buses on December 5th of 1955 as a result of these arrests. The arrest of Rosa Parks drew attention to the problem of bus segregation and mobilized African Americans to boycott the Montgomery buses by refusing to use them. This caused the court to rule bus segregation unconstitutional years later. The Supreme Court then passed laws against bus segregation throughout the country.
In Alabama and throughout the country, the desegregation of public transportation was culminated by the boycott. The movement is best known for catapulting the career of a young Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The boycott was largely planned and executed by African American women. The boycott almost lasted for a year, despite the threats and violence. On December 20th, 1956, the Supreme Court upheld a lower court decision that stated it was unconstitutional to discriminate on public transit. Civil rights activists turned their attention to the integration of public schools with the success of the Montgomery bus boycott.